We all set, Jerry? Excellent, good. So we'll be together for a couple of weeks and we're going to learn all about kidneys. But most of what we'll do today is look at fluids independently of the kidneys. Most of you aren't going to become nephrologists, although you can see we dearly need you to be nephrologists, but probably most of you every single day will be concerned with fluid balance. So we will spend about 3 hours today on fluid balance. So my objectives, I have to do a little bit to try to get you through the shelf exam, okay? But getting you through the shelf exam doesn't necessarily make you prepared to be docs. So I will try to do a little bit more than just get you through the shelf exam. Not everything I do is designed to be testable. And I will try to point out what I think is important for tests and what's just important generally. So Costanzo, love Costanzo, good book. So, and I don't know, we're well into the course. This is the latest edition. If you've got a blue book that's an older edition, it's not much different. So you should be good to go with whichever Costanzo you have. By default, I will start on the hour and try to finish 10 minutes before the hour. If you want that to be changed, let me know and we can be accommodating, but that's the default position. I've also got a note here that we need to do something about office hours. How have we been doing that? How have other faculty dealt with office hours? Posted something or just said? Well, for right now, how have they been doing it, Dr. E.K.? Okay. Well, right now, I mean, I'll be here this afternoon after we finish, maybe tomorrow morning, and then I guess on Monday we'll talk again about when I'll be around, for sure. I try to follow. I've got these handouts. They're kind of brief. They're not dense at all. The idea of these handouts is not to tell you everything that you have to know, but the idea is that it's kind of a skeleton, and you can add your own notes to the handouts. I am not going to be doing PowerPoints. And one of the reasons is that PowerPoints are just a wonderful excuse for professors to do an information dump on you. I think that that's fine in a lot of topic areas, but I think in renal physiology, I really think it is well worth trying to slow down a little bit, and I'm going to write everything pretty much on the board. When I write on the board, we have to slow down somewhat. And so hopefully, we'll just focus on the information that's really important. So, I said I don't use slides. I'm done with slides. I told you that, oh gosh, who likes the Nernst equation? Nobody. Who likes the Fick equation? Nobody. Gee, you guys don't like math, do you? Well, there's just a teeny weeny bit of math in renal physiology also. However, I think we can get all the complicated math out of the way. So if you have a solution, the concentration of that solution, concentration equals the mass of the solute in it divided by the volume of the fluid, right? It's just a statement of fact. So in renal physiology, we need to learn to manipulate that equation. So that's one manipulation. And the other, volume equals mass over concentration. That's 80% of the math that we need to do. And since I'm not mathematically inclined either, I'm going to post this up here just in case I lose track of that. Okay. We'll work with that a little bit more, but basically just about everything we do is going to be based on those relationships. There is another one you need to know, but I don't think you're going to forget this one either. Pressure equals flow times resistance. And be able to manipulate that equation. And the only other quantitative concept that I really want you to know is what goes in usually comes out. So that's most of the quantitative stuff. And I will try wherever possible to make it fairly straightforward. So my recommendation would be to have these handouts or notes in front of you, whether it's on a screen or whether it's printed out. And so this is the first one we're going to start on. And about 30 years ago, I determined that every presentation or every lecture should be preceded by a clinical case. And I think that idea permeates a lot of basic sciences now. So the title is Basic Renal Processes. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to spend a few minutes just talking about very global aspects of the kidney. But I would like to point out that on the next page, patient study, Mr. Good. This is what I think, does Rural Track do this too? Okay. But all of you in CBL were using this case yesterday. And the way that I plan to use this is that after every day, the finish of every day, I'm going to ask you a bunch of questions about Mr. Good that kind of relate to the time that we spend in the last hour or two. And so it's kind of a workshop. The answers are on D2L. I don't plan to go through it, but the answers are all there. You can do a workshop by just going and looking up the answers. You know, you guys are all adults. You can do it any way you want. Generally, I don't want to be patronizing and tell you how to study, but generally, making mistakes and going through a workshop is often the best way to learn. It is for me, anyway. So I'll often make mistakes. So I'm not going to go through this right now because you went through it yesterday. Let's get straight on and go to page, 234? Yeah, page 4. So, just in very general terms, if you were to ask somebody on the street, I would like to convince you that there are three major functions of the kidney. And I don't want to be obscure about it. One, two, three.